Welcome back to the Lean Discovery Applied series. I'm Clinton Sanko with my guest, Dave Lewis, Chief Data Scientist of Brainspace. You joined Brainspace as Chief Data Scientist in June of 2016, and it's always fun when we're doing these kind of interviews to go back and look at the press releases from the time to see what they say about, you know, the expectations for Dave Lewis on a look-forward basis. And the press release at that time said that your deep experience in text analytics and data science will be valuable as Brainspace amps up its ability to address increasingly complex litigation, corporate investigations, and government intelligence. Now, focusing for our in-house counsel audience on corporate investigations and complex litigation in particular, there's always this concept, there's always this tension of these big data sets and wanting to find what's super important quickly and ultimately be as efficient and effective as you can be in finding what's relevant and responsive and making your production in litigation. So focusing on that, what specific technical improvements have you pioneered over the last 4 years that are now kind of baked into the fabric of Brainspace, the product that's currently on the market?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I mean, I think a big part of my focus, unsurprisingly, has been supervised machine learning, that is teaching the computer by example. And, you know, I think the big first mission that I took on was what eventually led to CAML. And that's to get away from the notion that supervised learning is this very heavyweight process. I think, you know, the TAR 1.0 models were modeled on a traditional manual review where you had kind of big batches of documents and it's a almost sort of an industrial assembly line kind of workflow and whatnot. And I had always felt that really supervised learning could be like search. You know, search used to be this scary thing that only like a few librarians and things did. Now everyone uses search. You know, you go to this web page, you type in a few words and whatnot. And, you know, my goal was to try to make supervised learning that easy. And I think we went a very long way to making the use of supervised learning a lot easier. It's probably not quite yet to the point where you can just type a few words into a box. So I've got some ideas about that. It's supervised learning in Brainspace 6.0 and forward is fluidly integrated through the entire product. Anywhere you are, anytime you find a document, you can tag it and it becomes a training example if you want that. And as opposed to, okay, now I'm going to create a big control set. Now I'm going to create this big thing. Now I'm going to do supervised learning. Now supervised learning is something you can do just sort of very fluidly as part of whatever your natural workflow would be, whether it's for an investigation, whether it's exploratory and ECA, or as part of or as part of kicking off a review process in a more conventional litigation. So that's been, and then in, you know, now with 6.3 that just got released, you know, a big focus there then has been further automation. So in those circumstances where it's not so much a kind of human being intensely involved in the interface, but maybe you really are more traditional litigation and maybe you're coding your documents in relativity with 50 people and whatnot. Well, then, sad as it may be, you want Brainspace's interface to disappear and you just want to be doing your thing in relativity. And so we now have this very sophisticated automation framework where you can turn it on once and do this thing in relativity and do what you always do in relativity, and Brainspace is running behind the scenes. You don't see the beautiful UI, but all the algorithms are running. So those are the big theme of my work at Brainspace has been there. But then there's been a ton of back behind the scenes things you never see, improvements, the, you know, efficiency of supervised learning, effectiveness, better active learning, you know, even, you know, mundane stuff like better duplicate detection and appropriate handling of those duplicates statistically and, you know, foreign language things. I go on and on. There's, you know, a lot of it's not sort of like very sexy stuff. It's just the routine engineering that keeps a product moving forward. And it's a ton. I mean, I spend a ton of time talking to our clients and reading support tickets and whatnot, and just doing these little incremental advances all the time. And I have a very good team of engineers who does that.